Good mornings from Glasgow. Welcome to the jungle. I'm Aiden.
And I'm Tyson.
We hope everyone had a great Christmas break.
Did you know that today is National Winnie the Pooh Day?
Other than Winnie the Pooh, it's also, you know, around Martin Luther King Jr. Day, January 16th. As a wise man once said,
I have a dream.
On to our first segment, Spring of Stars with Luke. I'm Luke, and this is Spring with Stars. Today we have with us Jacob Adams, who's on the bowling team. Jacob, thanks for being here.
You're welcome.
So Jacob, what is your favorite part about bowling?
Bowling is like an interactive sport, and it's not really a sport, it's more of a leisure sport. And you interact with other people from different schools and, you know, just hang out, go to the bowling alley.
Yeah, and besides that, Jacob, what do you do?
I play football. I'm in the Beta Club, Key Club, and Student Council, and, you know, I just like to do
whatever. Nice. So, what's your favorite subject?
My favorite subject is World History with Coach Slaughter. It's my favorite one.
And this is always in my segment. What is your favorite letter on the Tiger Code?
My favorite letter on the Tiger Code is encouragement, because I feel like we can always give encouragement to others and help build each other up.
That's great. I'm Luke, and this was Spring with Stars. See you next time.
Thanks, Luke. It's always great to see some of our Spring with athletes around the school.
Totally. Now onto my twin and Ashlyn to see how good best friends know each other at SHS. On this week's Jungle, we will be finding out which pair of best friends know each other the best.
Today I'm here with Peyton Griffin and Brady Seaman, and today we'll be seeing how good they know each other.
Okay, Brady, what is Peyton's favorite sport that he plays?
That's 1 point.
Peyton, what is Brady's favorite candy?
Ha! Hey! Ha!
Another one!
Brady, how did you pay me? Hey, who is Brady's favorite teacher?
Yes!
Brady, what is Peyton's biggest fear?
Oh!
Today we are here with Braden Minton and Eli Patterson to see how good of friends they are. Eli, when is Minty's birthday? Minty, how did you and Eli first meet?
No, oh, what'd you put?
I put Slaughter's class, 10th grade.
Eli, who is Minty's favorite teacher? Minty, who is Eli's favorite band?
Easy.
3 for 4.
Easy.
Today we're here with Riley Froman and Olivia Carroll, and today we'll see how good of friends they are. Riley, when is Olivia's birthday?
My dog.
Olivia, where is Riley's favorite place to shop? Riley, who is Olivia's favorite teacher? Olivia, who is Riley's favorite artist?
Oh.
Riley, what is Olivia's biggest fear?
Same. Back to you, Tyson.
Thanks, Twin and Ashlyn. That was very funny.
Now on to Scarlett, Candace, and Olivia, who got some students' perspective on New Year's resolutions.
Thanks, Tyson and Aiden. Today, we are asking around the school what their New Year's resolutions are for 2023.
Hi, I'm Miss Weston, and my 2023 one word is conquer. And I chose that word because there's a lot of things that I want to conquer this year. For example, I bought a Peloton bike, but it's a dupe, not that expensive. It's a cheaper version. And my first week and 2 weeks of January is just to ride my bike 10 minutes per day.
Hi, my name is Colby Ellis, and this is my 2023 New Year's resolution. For this year, I want to do better at football and eventually get an offer or something like that.
I'm Chandler Chancellor.
I'm Wesley Cove.
My New Year's resolution is to get my money up, not my funny up. You hear me?
My New Year's resolution is to lose some more weight.
Hi, I'm CJ Shipp, and my New Year's resolution is to be a better person. I think I could be a better person in no time, and that I want to be a better tenor and choir.
I am Jocelyn Gutierrez Mello, and my 2023 resolution is to make my parents proud.
My New Year's resolution is to get the bag.
Thank you. Back to you, Jocelyn Aiden.
Whoa, I wonder how long those are going to last.
Who knows? Good luck to everyone in resolutions this year. Now to Candace and Mari to ask people their predictions for the national championship game.
Today we're going to be asking people about the TCU and Georgia game and asking about their opinions about who's going to win and what the final score is going to be.
Today I'm here with Brooke McQueen, and we're going to be asking you a question about tonight's national championship game. What do you think the final score will be tonight?
I think it's going to be 34-21.
And who is your favorite player on the Georgia Bulldogs?
Brock Bowers.
Thank you.
Today I'm here with
Coach Floyd.
And we're going to be asking a few questions about tonight's national championship game. Who do you think is going to win tonight?
I think Georgia is going to win. I want TCU to win, but I think Georgia's going to win.
And what is your final score tonight?
It's going to be 37-21.
Thank you. Go Frogs.
Today I'm here with
Kevin Shaw.
And we're going to be asking a few questions about tonight's national championship game. Who are you going for?
I'm playing for TCU.
And what do you think the final score will be?
I'm usually not one to give an estimate on the final score, but I would say that TCU keeps it close until the second half. Georgia pulls away 49-31.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Today I'm here with
Ransom Wingate.
And I'm going to ask a few questions about tonight's national championship game. What is your final score prediction?
I'm not one to predict the final score, but I definitely think it's going to be close, probably within 2 touchdowns. It's not going to be a blowout.
And who's your favorite on the Georgia Bulldogs?
Probably to go with Carson Beck or Vlad McConkey.
Thank you. Today I'm here with Harper.
And
today we're going to be asking a few questions about tonight's national championship game. Who do you think is going to win?
Georgia.
And what do you think the final score will be?
I got Georgia 55-15.
Go Frogs. Today I'm here with
Cooper.
And I'm going to be asking you a few questions about the national championship game tonight. Who do you think is going to win tonight?
I think TCU is going to win.
And what do you think the final score will be?
42-23.
Thank you.
Bradley.
Today we're here with Grant. He had the closest score, 55-15, of the national championship game. What were your opinions on the game?
Me personally, I think Alabama and Tennessee could have done way better than TCU did. I feel like it would have been cut to like a 20-point game at least. And yeah, TCU is just absolutely terrible team.
Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you.
Wow, I don't think anyone could have predicted how that game turned out, but Ransom got pretty close.
Yeah, it was not a close game. TCU got blown out. But now on to Cortez with some motivational words for the new year.
What it do? It's your boy Tez, the crew. We back at you know, so I ain't even gonna do all that, but you know, I'm just gonna get into the chase, like I said, you know. So I just wanna say a little PSMAR. A.K.A. little motivational speak, and today I'm going to talk about self-care.
Care!
You know, it is good that you have care in yourself.
Self!
If you do not have care in yourself, then you do not have good wealth.
Wealth.
Think. You have to think with your brain, not with her brain, or his brain, or his brain.
Your brain!
Your brain, exactly. Like I said. You know what I'm saying? You're the only one who can motivate yourself.
Self!
You're the only one that's going to get yourself up in the morning when you got to go to school.
Get up!
And one more thing that I would like to say is make sure you have love within yourself.
Love within yourself!
It has been your boy Tez with a little PSMR. You know what I'm saying? Doing what I'm doing. I'm still doing what I'm doing. I know y'all miss me. Don't worry, I'm going to get back out there.
Wicka,
Tiz!
For sure!
Thanks, Cortez, for the inspiration to focus on self-care.
That is always a good reminder. Now let's go check in with Emma and Cooper on the latest at SHS Sports.
Good morning, SHS. This is Cooper with the Sports Emma. And did you know that on this day, the University of Iowa put together an experimental basketball game with student athletes from the University of Chicago? Chicago won 15-12. And now on to Emma with basketball.
On January 10th, the Springville Lady Tigers and Varsity Boys took on Moody at home in a big area game. The Lady Tigers played a tough game and went into overtime, coming up a little short, losing 49-50. The Varsity Boys played an outstanding game, winning 70-56.
Thanks, Cooper and Emma. Please go out and support your Tigers.
That's all we have for you today. Be sure to follow us on Instagram and Facebook at SHS4.
Also, check out our online newspaper at shsroar.com.
Bye.